There's not a lot of point in bringing him out to show you. He's not going to do anything. He's just going to sit there and go, well, actually, I don't need to fly around today, mate. Just an ounce overweight would have a massive effect on our bird not doing anything. Because his head's telling him, if we don't burn any energy off by flying about, we actually don't need to eat anything today. So then he wouldn't do anything. I'd be stood there rubbing on about birds, and he'd just stand there and look at me. So we have to do a lot of weighing, a lot of routine of weighing. So when I finish in a minute, when Ben comes out the next bird, I'm going to run around the corner, I have to go weigh him again. Because as you see, every time I call him to a post, he has a bit of food. So we need to figure out how much food he's had while he's been flying around. Because as we said, he only eats 2 ounces of food today. Because we need him to come out and do it again tomorrow. If we give him too much, that's what we have to do. So any of the birds that you've seen on their own are birds that we fly. Anything on its own tethered, or on its own in an aviary, is a bird that's part of our working team. The other birds that you'll see in the aviaries, they're together as pairs. A lot of those are retired display birds. They've been and done all this bit before, in the first half of their life. It's a bit like this bird. So in the wild, he would only live for about 6 or 7 years. I say Rage is now 17 this year, and we expect him to live till he's about 25, maybe 30 years of age. So they live a lot longer, because life in captivity is so very easy, so very simple. But we can't really fly him for 30 years, that's a bit harsh, when they're designed to live for 6. So what we look to do is sort of cut their time with us in half. For the first half, they're part of our working display team, then we retire them, pair them up, and for the second half of their lives, they just chill out in the aviaries.